You see, by that time in history, the British Empire had been built on the control of the sea. They were able to drive ships around the world. They knew the world was a sphere. A flat world had gone out. But knowing that the world is a sphere is a very important thing for mankind. It means its surface is finite. And if it's finite, then there's not more space over there and more there. It's just so much. So they began immediately to inventory Earth. And this was one of the jobs of the East India companies. And Thomas Malthus, who taught at Haileybury College, which was the East India College, was the director of economics there. And it was his job. He was the first person ever assigned to the job of inventorying the Earth. Where does tin come from? Where does iron come from? And so on. And in the process, they began to find out how many different people there were in the world, how many different types of people, how many races of people, and where everything was, began to map the world. Well, that's a very important function, but it leads you to one more thing that has governed a relationship between countries ever since then, because Malthus came up with this idea that the population is growing ever so much faster than the ability to raise food. And therefore, it wouldn't be long before mankind would run out of food and there would be a terrible loss of life. And it was very convenient that Darwin came along, working for the same employer, the East India Company, with the idea that, well, life is a race for the survival of the fittest anyway, and so the fittest survive. Now, those two theories, which are propaganda, sort of made it legal for the people who invaded, the colonialists, to kill off a couple hundred thousand people, because first of all, they probably weren't going to get to eat anyway, and certainly they weren't the fittest, because they're not alive now, they're dead, we're the fittest. It backed up the idea of this proprietary colonialism that swept the world from that period right on up into the 19th century, and in some respects applies today, because look what's going on in Europe. Look what went on in Vietnam, where hundreds of thousands of people were killed. And the feeling was, you know, what they used to call the mere gook idea, that, well, it doesn't matter. They're not going to live anyway. It's a very powerful underpinning to the civilization today.